Okay, so we have already studied about the Doric order and the Ionic order from the Greek architecture. Am I audible to everyone? Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so what we have read is that Doric order originated from the Western Greek, and it's the simplest order, and it's characterized by short faced heavy column with plain round capitals and which had no base. Okay, it is a height only 4 to 8 times its diameter. The column are most squat of all orders. The shaft of the Doric order is channeled with 20 flutes. The capital consists of necking, which is of a simpler form. Then we have this convex kind of edgeness, and the abacus is square. So basically we have like a simplest form of order, which is a Doric order. Then we evaluated it and made something with a like bigger capital, and it is called the Ionic order. And then we have some flowers and petal kind of structure to the capital, which is added later on, which is the Corinthian order. So these are the three basic orders which we have in Greek architecture. So in the upper half of the typical Doric order, we have a frieze, then entablator, which is divided into 12 triglyphs, which has vertical bands and is separated by the grooves. Then we have metopes, which are the reliefs between the two triglyphs. Then in the Greek form of Doric order come without an individual base. They instead are placed directly on the stylobate. So the bottom part in the Doric order is called stylobate. Then later on, with conventional base consisting of a plinth and a torus was added. And in the Roman version, when we talk in the Roman architecture, we have a Doric order which has a smaller proportion, and they appear lighter than the Greek orders. So this is a difference in the Greek and the Roman order, that because they have smaller proportions, they look lighter than the Greek order. So basically, there's a Parthenon in Athens where you can find these simple Doric orders. So I want you people to start sketching, make your files, and there you can sketch these Doric orders. And for an example, for a building, you can have this Parthenon, which is in Athens. Okay. The second one is the Ionic order. Okay, have you people your notes? Can someone explain what is Ionic order? Akriti?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you please explain what is Ionic order?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, take your time and just you may have written something, just read that out for us.
The Ionic order is one of the three
या ग्रीक ऑर्डर्स?
Yes, ma'am, orders of classical architectures, the other two being the Doric or and the
Yes.
The Ionic orders is one of the three Canyon orders of classical architectures, the other two being the Doric and the
Corinthian orders.
Corinthian. There are two lesser orders, the
Yeah.
mom is spelling nahi aa rahi hai samajh mein.
Okay, what you have written?
And mom, the rich variant of Corinthian called the composite orders
yeah
of the three classical Carnian orders, the Ionic orders as the narrowest columns.
Yeah.
Then the Ionic capital is characterized by the use of volutes. The Ionic columns normally stand on a base which separate the septa of the columns from the stylobate of platform, while the cap is usually increased with egg and dart.
Yes. So basically what it is that like it is cylinder, it has opposite volutes, and the HNS has decorated with eggs and dart motifs. The shaft has four flutes, then the Doric order, which like totaling it to like 24. Then the Ionic base have two convex modeling called tori, which is separated by scotia. Then the Ionic order is marked by antesis, a curved tapering in the column shaft. The column of the Ionic order is 9 times the lower diameter. The shaft itself is 8 diameter high. Then the architrave and the entablature commonly consist of 3-step band. The frieze comes without the Doric triangles and metope, and the frieze sometimes comes with a continuous ornament such as carved figures instead. Okay, so we have some carved figures as a ornamentation. What else do we have in Ionic order? Okay. In Athens, like you can see this Ionic order in Parthenon, and it has a proper Ionic frieze which is encircled the cella of the temple, which like there like are sorry the Pantheon is the temple which is surmounted by this Ionic orders. Okay. And then there are the Corinthian orders. So the Corinthian orders are the latest kind of orders when it comes to the Greek orders. So the first one is the Doric, then it comes to the Ionic, and third is the Corinthian. So basically jitne bhi changes hue hain wo proportion mein changes hai, and there's a huge difference with the capital of three of these orders. The basic one is the Doric order, which is the first order. The second one is the Ionic order, in which we have architraves and the capital is distinguished in like different parts, and we have some ornamentation on in the capital. In the third one, which is the Corinthian order, so we have this Corinthian order in both Greek and Roman architecture with like a minor variation, and it gives and rise to the composite order. So it is cylinder, fluted, and it has ornate capital decorated with two rows of acanthus leaves and four scrolls. So these have leaf patterns and there are four scrolls. It is commonly regarded as the most elegant of the three orders, and the shaft of the Corinthian order has 24 flutes. The column is commonly 10 diameter high. So like if the diameter is D, then the height, the total height is 10D. It's 10 times. Okay, so basic difference is like how you'll differentiate the three orders is through their capitals. So what I want you people to do, to write about three orders, then explain these with the figures. The next will be that you have to write the differentiation between these three orders. Okay, everyone is getting this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so what you have to do, you have to write about the three orders, sketch them with the examples, and sketch the examples as well. Then you have to, the next question will be the differentiation between the three orders. The first is Doric, Ionic, and Corinthian. And then we'll start with some interiors work and what kind of work we have in Greek, and like how they are differentiated between the Roman orders. We have five type of Roman orders. We'll be discussing in our next class. We have revised our Doric and Ionic order, and we have done with our Corinthian as well. So we have read about all the orders, and now we'll be doing some interiors, and we will go through the Roman orders as well. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
So this is your first assignment. I want you people to submit it in your next class, okay, in the classroom tab itself. Okay, just sketch it, complete your assignment, click a picture, make a PDF, and then send it in the classroom tab. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay, you people can leave now.